Well, we are on a shelter between Aiget and Särve, and I met this nice German guy, Markus, and he showed me a homemade, what we call stove.
Yes, spirit stove.
Yes, and I was very impressed. Can you...
So, fill it up.
Yes.
And then put a little bit on the side.
And you have made this from two
soda
bottom
cans.
Of a can.
Yes.
And the broad one under is from a
regular can.
Yes, regular can. Yes. And I can show it's not many gram.
So.
And you can put it directly.
You just need a little bit, it's already a bit too much, but normally a little bit, just to heat up the stove. So it takes a bit.
Have you met another with a similar stove?
I haven't met one yet, no.
No.
But I know they are quite, because they're easy to make. And
it's not so expensive.
Cheap and lightweight.
Yes.
But it takes a bit now. You get the nice flame.
Yes.
Poured a bit too much.
And...
But you already see the...
And this you put outside here is for...
For heating.
Heating the...
Yes.
Take this, yes, like some kind of spirit, ethanol.
Ethanol.
Yes.
Fruit spirit. Okay.
I see the yeah. Gas is,
I had a bit too much on the
yes,
outside.
But,
normally, you need a bit less.
And when you take match, it's just 1 minute or some minutes,
yes.
And you get your strong flames.
But you already see it. It's the like the vapor coming out.
But you need a. Metal.
Yes,
to put it on, you don't put it on like
no,
this.
No. I always put it on the metal or
yes.
on the stone.
Okay. And now you have finished the spirit you put.
Yes, the outside is
outside
now
is
gone.
Now
yeah. It's just the vapor.
Yes.
Which is.
Can you lift it up just a little bit?
Then you see it.
Yes, like a Trangia.
Yes, like.
But cheaper and not so heavy. Well, I'll.
It's really good.
Yes.
Now you have the. This is how it burns then. This is. It's okay.
Okay.
It's quite good.
Thank you for demonstrating this.